Alright, so today we have kind of a different video. It's not the usual monthly recap. We wanted to do a deep dive on customization. Over the last few months, we've worked a lot on customization features on Evernote, both on desktop and on mobile. We were curious to have this like resource that we could give to anybody who's looking to understand better how customization works on Evernote and all the powerful things you can do to set up your Evernote so that it reflects very well how you use it. And just so you can focus on the things that are most relevant to you without the risk of it becoming like too complex and too hard to work with. Okay, so let's see what we can do on desktop. Let's say, for instance, that I don't want to see home and files on my sidebar. I can just go here, right click and press hide from sidebar. I can do this and now it's not there anymore. Let's say I want to do the same for trash and for tags. All right, now I don't need to see them anymore. As you probably noticed, there is this new more section. If I click it, I will see home, tags, and trash, which are exactly the sections that I hid right a second ago. Of course, this is not the only way to do it, and there's a way to bring back the things that I hid. So for instance, if I go here on more and click customize sidebar, it will open the settings, which I can also access in the usual way from by clicking on the on my name here. And I can go here and re-enable things that I might have disabled by mistake. I can also control the sidebar from here. So for instance, I can say, okay, I don't want home, I don't want templates, I don't want files, I don't want tags or share with me, and maybe I don't even want shortcuts. So in this way, you will see in real time here that the sidebar is becoming much less cluttered. There's also another thing that I can do, which is I can decide to show or hide the task and event creation buttons. So for instance, if I hide them by clicking on this button, it will hide those two buttons. If I go here now, it will give me those two buttons in the three dots menu. There are a couple more customization options here. If you are super interested in having your sidebar very lean and tidy, you can just hide more. So this way you will not be able to access the hidden sections anymore. You will need to come back to the settings and show more again, or enable individually the sections that you want to have. And the other thing is that if you want, you can hide the recent notes from the shortcuts. So for instance, if you expand your shortcuts, you will see both the shortcuts that you have manually selected and the recent notes that you last opened. You can decide to hide those. Personally, I really like an approach where I have a minimal sidebar, but I still see some things. So for instance, I'm not a huge task user, but I do use calendar. I use shortcuts quite a bit, and I like having notebooks always expanded, and I love having the more buttons so that I can always quickly add things if I need to. And I don't want to see the two buttons there. So what I can do now is just have this, which is much, much cleaner than what I had before. All right, let's change the background because now I'm sharing my phone screen. So let's take a look at how you can customize Evernote on your mobile phone. The default navbar setting that you have is this one where you have create, notes, notebooks, tasks, and more. Now, as I open more, you see that I can also navigate to shortcuts, calendar, tags, shared, and spoiler alert, templates. But basically, after a few iterations, we understood that this was a good default setup, and the more option allowed people to more easily navigate to important sections. But exactly as on desktop, we quickly realized that different people need different quick access to different sections, basically. So now let's navigate to the settings menu. And here on navigation, you can do two things. First of all, you can decide which page opens by default when you open the Evernote app from scratch, like when it's not open already in the background, but when you launch it. This allows you to land directly on the thing that you use the most. So for some people's workflow, The most important thing is to land on the create page, and that is why this is the default, because of the create page, you're there and you can quickly open it. It's very fast, super lightweight, it loads instantly, and you're in a page that allows you to create very, very quickly a new note, a new task, take a short note on the scratch pad, or create a new notebook through the button, or other items. And so you can decide that your default page is notebooks, for instance. And so when you open the app, you will directly go in this page. But you can also decide another thing that is even more deep as a customization, which is the navigation. If you come here, you will see that you can have create notes, notebooks, tasks, and more. But if I deselect create, for instance, the items are going to be 3 plus more at the top there, so that's the preview of how the navbar will look like. And let's say I want tags there, I can have tags. I guess many people will probably do something like, I don't know, create, notes, notebooks, and shortcuts. So this is something that you might want to customize. Please note that if we go back to the default launch page, you can have any page you want, not only the ones that you selected to have quick access from the navbar, because now they are all in the more menu. Now, as you see, I have create, notes, notebooks, and shortcuts. Plus, in the more section, I can see more of them. All right, this is it. So thank you all very much for watching. I'm very proud of the team for all the work that's been done on customization and on navigation. I think Evernote is in a much better place when it comes to performance, customization, and navigation, both on desktop and on mobile, when compared to a year ago, for instance. Props to the team. And yeah, I'll see you in the next video, which will most likely be the one about the November updates.